Conde Boccio, siamo su Solaris 111, una barca importante, la più grande.
Today with the boat show we're on board the Solaris 111, a very important boat, the largest ever built by this shipyard, and it's been built especially for the president of the Solaris group, which includes Solaris Yachts, Solaris Power, CMB, that is the latest addition to the group, and Performance Boats, which is the actual builder of this unit.
Quando ho visto la prima volta un Solaris 72, era impressionato dalla qualità.
When I first saw a Solaris 72, I was impressed by the quality of the work, by the wood and the carpentry that has been used inside. It was a hull by Doug Peterson, a very beautiful and elegant boat. I really liked it a lot, so I bought this boat. I asked the shipyard if they could send me the drawings, since I have an architectural engineering office in Luxembourg. So I developed the whole interior design of the boat, according to my ideas on how to live on a boat with the family and so on. Then, 6 months later, they asked me if I wanted to start a collaboration with the Solaris group. I accepted because I think it's an impressive skilled workforce employed at this construction site.
Solaris 111 è disegnato dall'argentino Soto Acebal che firma.
Solaris 111 is designed by Argentine Soto Acebal, who also designs everything else regarding the naval engineering of Solaris production. It is 33.77 meters long and 7.9 meters wide. It has a lifting keel that brings the maximum draft slightly over 6 meters. The total weight is 75 tons, 19 of which are in the bulb and 9 are in the fin.
Il piano velico è realizzato in maniera che sia gestibile da due persone.
The sail plan is made in such a way that it can be managed by two people. Self-tacking jib, important mainsail, and for the adjustments there are two magic trims in the bilge which, of course, as you know, are operated with the magical buttons on the helmsman dashboard. The total area is 645 square meters. There is a Southern Spars carbon mast. The mast and the shrouds weigh a ton and a half. It may seem a lot, but for a boat of this size, it's very little.
Una barca del genere per questa dimensione è davvero poco.
Lightning work also for the winches. They are made of carbon, lots of carbon. The only part made of metal is where the sheet is wound.
Siamo nella cabina dell'armatore.
We're in the owner's cabin aft of the boat. More or less, the helm wheels are here. The space is about 40 square meters, like a small studio apartment in the center of the city. There are two bathrooms, one for him and one for her. But what really matters is that there is an exit to the terrace.
La poppa è sempre stata una zona privilegiata delle grandi.
The stern has always been a privileged area on large sailing boats. In the past, on the vessels, there was the captain's office and his cabin, the officer's meeting room and large windows facing the sea.
Verso il mare.
This is not the first pleasure boat in which the stern is used for noble purposes. It is certainly a great solution. Now let's go out on the sea.
Usciamo verso il mare. Ed eccoci nelle
terrazze. Here we are on the aft terrace. There are sofas and stairs to dive into the sea. I'd say a true pleasure spot.
Assoluto piacere. Una volta però.
However, in the past, this part of the boat was called quarterdeck, from which comes the term quartering wind. That comes from behind. This area was even used as a space where to grow plants.
Vivavano davvero le piante.
There are many other large and quick boats whose owners, when entering the port at evening, decide to go to sleep in a hotel. I didn't want that. I want to stay in my beautiful cabin on the boat with all the luxury available.
Una cosa per me era molto importante che le timoni sono abbastanza in avanti e quando siamo al motore io c'ho la mia partita dietro.
A very important aspect for me was that the wheels had to be forward enough because when we navigate by engine, I have my own private area behind the helmsman where it's quiet and there's no one else, where I can have my privacy on the boat. I also decided to set up an aft cabin because in the morning when you get up, the first thing you want to do immediately is have contact with the water. I really like it, and I'm very happy I decided to design this cabin at the stern. In fact, in the evenings, we always stay out here. We dine here, we chat and play until 2 a.m, even with the kids, the family and friends. But at the same time, we don't bother the crew because their cabins are up front. They have their own privacy. We don't want to run into each other.
Hanno la loro privacy, così c'è nessuno che si incrocia.
Nella scelta delle dimensioni della barca si è fatta tanta attenzione alla possibilità di realizzare all'interno dei volumi importanti senza però.
When choosing the size of the boat, great attention was paid to the possibility of creating important interior volumes, without however exaggerating with the overall weight and displacement, which in the end came to be even lower than that of the project. 75 tons of displacement with no load compared to 79 tons of the project. 4 tons are not much, but they indicate a precision in the construction which exceeds indications of the designer. Carlo Torre, who is the naval architect of Monaco Yacht Temptation, took part in the setup of the interiors. He stepped in after the design was made, but brought in some new features and important elements.
Per gli interni è stato scelto il legno di noce per allontanare.
For the interiors, they chose walnut wood essences instead of the traditional teak. There are light fabrics and they even fitted carpet in some areas. Everything is quite simple, perhaps minimal, but very concrete with a marine style.
Molto marino. Il layout degli interni prevede la cabina armatoriale a poppa, due cabine ospiti.
The interior layout includes the owner's cabin aft, two guest cabins amidships and a VIP in the bow, next to the crew quarters, which can accommodate 5 people. It's a very important boat. This is the living area.
La dinette. Tavolo apribile che accomoda molti ospiti e una zona divani con
an opening table that comfortably hosts many guests and a sofa area with several possibilities to lie down to comfortably read or chat.
Mi piace moltissimo il Mediterraneo, penso che un bellissimo mare.
I really like the Mediterranean Sea. I think it's wonderful. You can reach places such as Palma de Mallorca, Ibiza, Sardinia, Croatia, Greece and Turkey. I think the Mediterranean is a sea full of wonderful sports. It's quite unique in the world.
È unico quasi al mondo.
Stiamo finalmente navigando a vela, una quindicina di nodi reali. Vento al giardinetto, velocità della barca attorno ai 10, abbiamo su tutta la randa e il fiocco. La randa è abbastanza cazzata, le vele sono abbastanza cazzate perché come tutti i Max.
We are finally sailing, almost 15 knots of real quartering wind and our speed is around 10 knots. We have fully opened the mainsail and the jib. The mainsail is pretty hauled, as are the sails. And that's because, like on every Maxi, there's a lot of apparent wind which blows more on the bow. This boat has been built in prepreg carbon laminate, which means the fibers are soaked with the resin that is needed in the optimal proportion, and then, after the application, with the Gearit vacuum sprint system, a post-cure that leads to catalyzation occurs. In this case, the post-cure phase occurs at 90 degrees, that is, the hull is heated in an oven up to a temperature of 90 degrees. Now we are navigating upwind. Guys, we are running on the water. 14 knots and the wind blows at 18 to 20 knots. This is a real maxi, great pace, although it takes large spaces in front.
Volete sapere come si timona questa barca? Beh, come tutte le altre. In realtà i registi hanno ormai imparato a rendere molto più.
Do you want to know how to wheel this boat? Well, like all the others. In fact, designers have now learned to make even such large boats very sensitive to the wheel. In the past, there was a little more of the train effect. Actually, you can feel the sea, and this is very pleasant. It's what the owners like. You have to foresee the wind gusts well in advance. You have to adjust the mainsail immediately. And then there is one important thing. It's always nice to see the log over 14 knots.